The first electronic computer in Israel was built in 1954 in the Weizmann Institute of Science and was called the WEIZAC.
Everybody at the beginning thought that this is a nonsense to build here a computer. In fact, there was a committee set up at the Institute for Advanced Study consisting of five members. The three ranking members were John von Neumann, Einstein, and Robert Oppenheimer. And Einstein said, what does such a tiny country need, will do with such a huge computer? But he was persuaded by John von Neumann. And so Weizmann was persuaded to assign 1/5 of the annual budget of the Weizmann Institute for the computer.
The WEIZAC was essentially a copy of the computer of the Institute of Advanced Studies in Princeton.
The high-tech industry started in Israel at a little shack which was run by two Bulgarian immigrants who ran a shop for producing spare parts for bicycles and fans. And they agreed to produce for us a chassis on which the components that we can see that at the WEIZAC. There was no infrastructure, there was nothing going on, no components, no staff, nothing. And Jerry Estrin came here to lead us. In Princeton, the high-speed memory consisted of 1K, or 1,024 words only. And we had already four times as much, 4K. That meant that the whole main control had to be redesigned. And that was my job. And that was a very exciting time. So at night, Jerry Estrin and Zvi Riesel sat trying to debug my design. A frequent visitor at these nocturnal sessions was Chaim Leib Pekaris, who initiated the whole project. He had seen in Princeton, even before in World War II, what computers can do. And he agreed to come here to lead the Applied Math Department on the condition that there would be a computer here. Then in 55 came the day where we wanted to apply voltage the first time to the computer. We turned on the voltage. And then black smoke billowed to the ceiling and fires broke out and it was real fireworks. And the VIPs fled into all directions. Then we corrected everything and we turned it on without the VIPs, and that was okay. Suddenly, after millions and millions of operations, something goes wrong. What caused it? I remember that this was a very challenging thing that I specialized in. We used to run diagnostic programs designed to make the life very difficult to certain circuits. And at the same time, we lowered the voltage. So you just turned these knobs and that either increased or decreased the voltage of different circuits.
WEIZAC was much in demand, and there was a lot of competition between users at the Weizmann Institute and beyond seeking to use it.
One big user was the Army. Pekaris wanted all the time for himself. The Army had, I think, one weekly hour. But sometimes the army needed more time. So they called up Ben Gurion, who was the Minister of Defense. And Ben Gurion called up Mayor Weisgall, who was the Chancellor of the Institute. And so at 2 or 3 in the morning, the army got an extra hour from Pekaris.
The WEIZAC performed its first calculation in 1955. and was operational for 9 years until 1964. It was constantly busy, and this evidence of demand for computing helped to lay the foundation for Israel's computing industry.
The leading role that Israel plays in the international high-tech industry is really due to the WEIZAC years.